Student, next we discuss about electric lines of force and or electric field lines. What are electric lines of force? Okay, so suppose we take electric field. This electric field will represent the how much amount of force it acts on the other charge in this one. In case how much distance, how much area will be acts on the this force. Okay, simply said, this electric lines of force will give strength of the electric field. How much strength of the electric field, how much intensity of electric field is arise around by the charge. Okay, so what are electric lines of force? Is this, or we can take plus Q charge, main charge, and this charge will be is there at any origin point. Now we have to release another plus Q charge, plus Q naught charge near to this one. Then what happen? This plus Q main charge or source charge will act repulsion force on them, then it will be pushed away. Similarly, this plus Q naught is placed at this point, then it is also pushed away at this point, at this point is also pushed away, at this point this is also pushed away. Okay, so this push away line is a imaginary line. It is a imaginary line. So this imaginary line surrounded by the electric field along which unit positive test charge will move, so that these lines are called electric field lines or electric lines of force. Simply said, what are the electric lines of force? These are the imaginary lines. Along this line, along this line, unit positive charge will move, are called electric lines of force. That is, mainly electric lines of force will represent the how much amount of intensity of electric field is arised surrounded by the charged particle. Okay, so that's why we have to take electric lines of force or electric field lines. Okay students, in case we have to take plus Q charge, these field lines is move away from this plus Q. That means these field lines are starting from plus Q charge, that is positive charge. In case we have to take negative charge, that is minus Q is there. Now we have to release plus Q naught charge. Then what happen? It will be attracted. Similarly, we have to place Q naught at this point, then it will be also attract. At this point, it will be attract, and at this point, it will be attract. So, due to minus Q charge, electric field lines will arise towards this negative charge. That's why we have to tell two points. One point is, these electric field lines are starting from positive charge and these are ending at negative charge. Ending at a negative charge. So we have to write neatly, due to plus Q charge, electric lines of force are move away from this one. In case we have to take negative charge, these lines are move towards this one. Okay, and we have to take two positive charges, that is like charges. Then what happens? So we have to take plus charge, positive charge. Similarly, we have to take another positive charge. What happened? At this first one, we have to release plus Q naught. Then what happened? It will be repulsed. And at this place, we have to place, then it will be repulsion. Similarly, plus Q naught is placed at this point, then it will be repelled. And place it at this point, it will be repelled. So, totally, we can take two positive charges near to this one. Then, these electric lines are not combined with each other. They are moved away from each other. That's why, simply said, light charges are ripple with each other based on this concept. Okay? So, next we have to take two unlike charges. What happened? Okay? Plus Q naught charge is placed at this point. What happened? It will be repelled. And that plus Q naught will be reaches to minus Q charge. Towards to minus Q charge. That's why this plus Q naught will move this direction, this part. And plus Q is placed at this point, then it will be moved this side. That's why totally we have to represent these electric lines of force due to plus Q, that is due to unlike charges. It will be form a loop, but not closed loops. Okay, because plus Q naught is placed at this point, it will be move only positive to negative. Not it's again move from negative to positive. So that's why we have to tell electric lines of force, electric field lines are open loops. They are called open loops. Very important point. Electric field lines of force are open loops because of they are starting from positive charge, ending at negative charge. Okay? And then they do not move from negative charge to positive charge. They are always move from positive charge to negative charge. Okay? And we can take another point is we have to take a straight conductor, straight metal plates. One is give positive charge and another one give negative charge, same amount of negative charge. What happened? So at this plus Q, at this charge, this total charge is, this is plus Q and this is minus Q, but total charge is Q. Consider total charge is Q. Okay, now we have to place at this point. We have to place at this point. We release a plus Q naught charge. We release a plus Q naught charge. What happened? It will be repelled and reaches to minus Q charge. This is the direction of the field. Okay? You understood this one? Now similarly, this plus Q is placed at this point, then it will be repelled and it reaches to plus Q. Similarly, these are also move from positive to negative. So these are represent the electric lines of force also. So mainly force direction will represent the electric field lines direction due to either due to positive or negative charge. So these field lines, in between these charges, the field lines are straight and parallel with each other. Straight and parallel with each other, and in this each and every point intensity of electric field is remains constant. Intensity of electric field is remains constant. So that's why we have to called this type of field is called uniform electric field. It is called uniform electric field. What is uniform electric field? Okay, so that the electric field strength at each and every point in an electric field is remains constant, then it is called uniform electric field. It will be different, it is called non-uniform electric field. Due to two positive charges, due to unlike charges, due to single positive charge, due to single negative charge, the lines are different, the lines are moves in different paths, in different directions. So, intensity of electric field is not remains constant, does not remains constant in each and every these four cases. So, these four fields are called non-uniform electric fields. Non-uniform electric fields. Non-uniform electric fields. Okay, friends, you remember this point? Okay, and we have to take conductor. Simply said, we have to take a sphere. Like this sphere, we have give positive charge, and we can take any sphere or any conductor. We can give some charge. Then this charge is always resides on the outer surface of the conductor. Okay. It's placed only outer surface of the conductor, not inside. Like, this charge is Q. Now this is plus Q. At this point, then electric field direction will be is there? Is outward direction. Similarly, in this also, outward. Similarly, in this also, all are also outside direction. So, we can take a conducting sphere. The electric field is always radially outside the sphere. It acts always radially outside the sphere. And we can take another example. Is we can take a metal plate. This is the metal plate. And we can give positive charge to him, to that one. So that's why the electric field lines or electric field direction is outside direction because of this is positive charge. Similarly, this side also can give electric field direction. And this is also represent the electric field lines direction because of we can take any point on its path. We can draw the tangent at any point on its electric field which gives direction of electric field. Which gives, in case we can take at this point P, we can draw the tangent at this point. We can say that this is the direction of electric field at this point. Similarly, this is also direction of electric field. E bar. This is very important point. Very important diagram also. And this is laterally we discussed. And similarly, in this also, electric field lines and electric field direction is also same, radially outward. And you remember this point, very important point is, in case direction of electric field, or once again I will tell you, direction of electric field, or direction of electric lines of force, is always perpendicular to the given surface of conductor. Given surface of conductor. For example, at this point we have to draw a surface. This is surface. Then the direction of electric field is perpendicular to this surface. Similarly, at this point this is perpendicular to this surface. And we have to draw this one. This is also perpendicular to the surface. Surface is there. This is not this one. This is placed this side. So electric lines positive is there. Electric lines positive is there. Positive is there. Then field lines will get this side. Field lines will get this side. So this is field lines is perpendicular to this surface. Okay, see this. Okay. So perpendicular to this surface. Perpendicular to this surface. Okay. So similarly, in this also, this is a conductor. So, this is also conducting plate. So, in this also, these lines will be perpendicular. Okay, simply said, we can take charges on any conductor, it will be resized only on its outer surface, and electric field lines are also or direction of electric field is always perpendicular to the given conductor. Okay, so we have to take another point. We can draw two electric field directions. For example, at this point we have to draw direction of electric field is this one. In case we can take a point P, another point P. At point P we can draw only one tangent. We know that at any point we can draw only one tangent, so that's why we have to tell at any point the electric field having only single direction. So that's why two electric lines of force do not intersect with each other. Okay, because of, in case they are intersect at each other, at the intersection point the field has two directions. For example, the electric lines of force move this side and the electric lines of force move this side. We consider this two lines are intersect with each other. Two fields are intersect with each other. In case if they are intersect at the intersection point P, the field has two directions. That is, this one direction, this one direction. But at any single point we draw a single tangent. So at any single point on the line we give a single direction of electric field. So these electric lines of force do not intersect with each other in any field. Okay, so these lines are move separate with each other. We have to draw many lines between two charges or from single charge, but each and every charge, every lines will separate to move. They do not intersect with each other. If they are intersect at the intersection point, field has two direction, which is not possible. In IPE, one question will be there. That question is, why two electric lines of force do not intersect with each other? Your answer is, if they are intersect with each other, at the intersection point, field has two directions. That is, electric field has two directions. So, which is not possible practically. That is your answer. Okay? So, this is the concept of electric field and electric lines. And one point is there. This electric lines of force number is always proportional to electric field. Why? Because number of lines will be increased at any part, then electric field, strength of the electric field is also increased. Near to charge, the group of lines will be increased, then electric field will be increased. And some distance, electric lines are move towards separate with each other. That is, they are some distance between them, so they are not crowd to move. So electric field, number of lines will be decreased, then electric field is also be decreased. Okay, so we have all are remember these points. Okay, thank you.